Chairman Doubleday.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and thanks to all the witnesses for being with us today. We really appreciate your time. I want to note, since we're discussing the needs of veterans as part of today's hearing, I recently was volunteering at one of the food banks in my district at Hope Link, and in my district, 40% of food bank client households have at least one person currently serving or who previously served in the military. And this number goes up to nearly 58% in King County in Washington State and at least 62% in Snohomish County. And as part of that, Madam Chair, I wanted to ask unanimous consent to insert into the record a letter from Food Lifeline, which is an organization fighting hunger in our district that elaborates on this even more. Thank you. I also wanted to go back to some of the discussion we've had on able-bodied adults without dependents and the cliff that we see when folks are unable to find employment programs or unable to find work. As we talked about earlier, nationwide, the ABOD cliff includes 60,000 veterans, 60,000, and according to the Center on Budget and Policy Priorities, over 40% of this vulnerable population are women. Close to one-third are over the age of 40, about half are white, a third are African-American, and a tenth are Hispanic, and we know that Native American populations will also be hit hard. I helped introduce legislation, the SNAP Work Opportunities Act, that would provide an exception to the three-month time limit for those looking for work in states that don't have the resources to offer them job training or workfare opportunities, and was noted, thanks to Ms. Liebman for pointing out, we've had a lot of work in my state of Washington on SNAP employment and training, education and training efforts, and we know that there are pilots now that we help start in the last farm bill that will continue to hopefully come up with great ideas of how we can use SNAP ENT to again help folks not need SNAP programs anymore because they are able to find jobs that allow them to be self-sufficient. But I wanted to hear more broadly from everyone on the panel today about how the cliff, the ABOD cliff, will hurt populations that you're representing. I know, Ms. Liebman, you talk a little bit, but are there others who can tell us a little bit more about how this has affected some of the folks that you've been working with?
Well, we at AARP at least know that there are potentially a million people affected, and it's serious enough so that we are looking at it and believe it may need a revision, and that work will go forward to take a careful look at it.
Mr. Ferris?
One of the challenges we have is that once a senior hits the poverty level, it's very hard for them to climb out of that poverty level, and work opportunities are not there. And we're talking about able-bodied seniors here as opposed to those that are homebound. It is very, very difficult for those that are needing work at that age when
Thank you.
It's not available to them.
Thank you. Mr. Schneiderlin, in your written testimony, you ask for Congress to keep work requirements for SNAP at their current level. Can you elaborate on why you've made that suggestion in your written testimony?
Well, pretty clearly right now among seniors, as I've said, the participation rate in SNAP is already quite low, in the 40% range versus 80% range of otherwise eligible people. So we think that any heightened work requirements would further reduce the participation. And really, it's critical to keep an increased participation because this is really a health and a healthcare cost issue. If we can keep people in their homes through SNAP benefits, they may then avoid institutional care, which can cost Medicare and Medicaid almost three times, particularly Medicaid, three times the amount that you would have to pay to keep them in home. And that's where they want to be, is at home. So we think that really the requirements should be liberalized rather than tightened, because this is a program that can save taxpayers money through reducing institutional care.
Thank you. Thanks again to all of you, and I yield back, ma'am.
Thank you. Chair recognizes